Hello everyone, I'm really glad to be with you today, and I know you are going to be very interested in watching this video, because I'm going to interview Father Kevin Ripley, who is our new priest celebrant here at St. Mary's. But before I do that, I'm wondering how many of you can now say the alphabet backwards after watching my little lesson on that a couple weeks ago. I did have a few people, I want you to know, come up to me last weekend who could recite the first part, which is the first seven letters, but haven't met anyone yet who can do that entire alphabet. Now just remember, if you learn to say the alphabet backwards, you would always know how to do something that most people can't do. Okay, let's get to the interview. Father Kevin was ordained on July 10th and has been with us since the beginning of August. I know many of you have not had the opportunity to meet him yet, so I thought this would be a good way for you to do that and learn a little bit about him at the same time. So we also decided to do this interview inside both of our churches, so those of you who haven't felt ready to come back to church yet can see our sanctuary spaces. So welcome, Father Kevin.
Thank you, Sister Pam.
As we begin this interview, I'm wondering if you could share with us a little bit about your family story, including your education, and how you decided to become a priest.
Okay, sure. I grew up in Pulaski, Wisconsin, with my older brother, Kyle, and my parents, Rick and Kathy. My brother and I went to Catholic grade school up until fifth grade, since that's what we had at the school. And I have a large extended family on both sides. So always growing up, we would get together for lots of holidays and we were always getting together for something, it seemed, birthdays and you name it. But so that was a very good thing. We'd go to Mass every Sunday as a family. Now, I didn't really think about priesthood until college. At least not too seriously. A little bit, maybe when I was younger, very young, and then maybe it kind of struck me in the high school years, but wasn't anywhere, I wasn't very into my faith, relatively to when I was in college. I went to UW-Madison to study mechanical engineering, and I ended up graduating from that right before going to seminary. And in college, I had a great Bible study that I met with every week, and some mentors, and the priests there at the Newman Center were very, very good examples of priesthood, and really, really helped me grow in relationship with Jesus. Eventually, many people started inviting me to consider, well, do you think you might be called to be a priest? And I really resisted that at first, but it really grew on me, and the Lord opened my heart to pray, God, what have you made me for? And little by little showed me that, yeah, he was inviting me to be a priest. So I applied to seminary my junior year, between my junior and senior year of college, and entered soon after that in 2014.
So I know you haven't been a priest for very long, but in this short time, what would you say like you love the most about being a priest?
Yeah, so celebrating Mass has been pretty great, especially that kind of daily routine of offering Mass and having that daily group of people to pray with is very special. Other than that, are confessions. Confessions have been amazing just to see what God is doing in people's lives.
And for those of us who have been at some of Father's Masses, you might know that he has a wonderful singing voice. And not only that, but also a wonderful voice for praying. I am always, you bring us truly into prayer, Father. I appreciate that very much. So in the midst of that, what might be a challenge that you see as you walk these first days as a priest?
There's a lot of new things to learn and to figure out how do I get everything done. At first there's just a lot to take in as a new priest. You know, in seminary we were prepared for very much and we spent time at parishes, but now I'm fully in it, you know, and a little by little I'm starting to understand and my shoulders are going down and I'm starting to get into the groove.
I'm sure that some days are pretty overwhelming regarding work and your ministry, but in between there, there has to be some time for fun. So what do you do for fun?
I do like to go biking and rowing. Oh. I have a rowboat. I've been going on Lake Butamore a couple times a week when I can find time when the wind is right. So that's been fun and good exercise. I also like just reading in the evenings.
Okay, and so what are you reading now? What are the pile of books by your bed?
Yeah, well, I just finished a book called Mary and the Crossroads of History by Father Rocky Hoffman, the chaplain of Relevant Radio. And that was very, very interesting, good to read about how Mary has been all throughout the world's history. And now I'm reading about Christendom and the current culture.
Okay. Yeah. Do you ever read anything that's fiction and mystery?
Do I ever read fiction? Yeah. I'd like to read more. Yeah, I like biographies.
Oh, okay.
Which is not fiction, but is a story.
Mm-hmm. Story.
I'd like to read more fiction. Okay. I'm drawn to the reality, the spiritual writings.
Right now.
Okay,
well, we definitely want to hear a little bit more about you, so we're going to get out of here for the moment, and we're going to head over to Amro, and we'll finish this interview then, okay?
Okay.
All right, let's go. Hello again, everyone. We are now at St. Mary's in Amro and ready to finish our interview with Father Kevin, our new priest celebrant. So, Father, what movies have you seen more than three times and would see again tomorrow in a minute?
Angels in the Outfield is an oldie that I really enjoy watching. And I watched it not too long ago again. I watched it a ton when I was younger, but I watched it more recently. And I was amazed at how much good, like, Christian or Catholic teaching is in there. Yeah, good one to have a little Bible study on or something.
Oh, that's great. So, are you?
It's a baseball movie, yeah.
And are you one of those people that could, like, probably say the words with the people as they're talking?
Some of them, yeah. Some of the lines, yeah. I'm not much of a movie line person. I have some friends who can spout out lines like nobody's business, but yeah, not me.
Okay. So, do you have a hero? Would you say that you have a hero in your life, or a model, or a saint, someone that you love to imitate and admire?
Yeah, it's kind of a toss-up between St. John Paul II and St. Teresa of Lisieux.
Okay, and reasons why?
St. John Paul II, I during college, I read a lot about him and learned a lot about him, and especially his teachings on love and responsibility. And theology of the body and all this, and just his involvement in bringing peace in the world at the time. His great inspiration for me when I was considering priesthood was John Paul II.
Okay.
I never got to meet him or go to a World Youth Day with him. That was later on. But Teresa of Lisieux, I mentioned biographies before. Her autobiography, The Story of a Soul, I've read about six times. And I just keep learning so much about confidence in God and her little way, which is the little way, she calls it, of remaining small before God, but having great confidence and great faith. So, yeah.
Great heroes, great people to model your life after. Yeah. So all the things that you're doing now as a priest, I'm sure there's a lot of things that you're not able to do. What's on that bucket list of yours?
Well, I wanted to go to Mexico earlier this year, which got canceled, especially to go to the Shrine of Our Lady Guadalupe in Mexico City. Mm-hmm. And I still have my plane tickets in hold on, the voucher. So as soon as it's open,
you'll be there.
I'd like to go. But with the schedule being a priest now, it's a bit more difficult, but I think we'll see if we can make it happen.
Okay, well, hopefully during those vacation days that voucher will still be in use.
Exactly.
And you'll be able to use it.
Right, right.
I don't know how you and Father Tom at home handle food and eating, but I'm wondering, are you a good cook? Is there a favorite dish that you like to make or eat?
I'm cooking more and more. I can, if I have a recipe, I can make whatever. I enjoy eating more than I do cooking, but it is worth the effort sometimes to really invest that time and make something special.
Do you have a special food?
Now, a special food, I really like barbecue ribs. Okay. I don't really make those very often, but I like to eat them a lot. Okay. I'm really good at making eggs, and I just got an air fryer, so I make really healthy French fries, steak fries.
Okay. And what goes with French those
toast,
steaks?
French toast is another thing I like to make.
Great. Yeah. So now everybody that's listening to this will know all your favorites. So when they start coming in baskets to your rectory, you'll know why. A favorite quote that you have, you know, we talked about saints and heroes in your life, but is there any line that guides you, a scripture quote or a famous quote from someone that you know that just runs around in your head during these days?
From scripture, yeah, one that comes from St. Paul. God makes all things work for the good of those who love him and are called according to his purpose. Okay. Really does come to mind a lot. Okay. So that God is working all things for the good, for our good.
And working through you as well.
Yeah, thank sure. You. Yeah.
Right. Anything else before we close today that you want us to know? We don't need to know all those deep, dark secrets of yours, but anything else as we close today that you want to leave us with?
Just thank you very much for having me here in Amro and Minnakami. I look forward to getting to know more people over these next number of years that I'm here with you. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, okay, thank you so much.
Well, you're welcome, and we thank you, Father Kevin, for taking time today to be both in Winnicott and then to come over here to Amro and help us get to know you a little better. We're glad to have you with us here at St. Mary's to celebrate Mass with us and the sacraments. So as you continue to get to know us a little better, we hope to get to know you a little better as well in the days and weeks ahead. So thank you very much, Father Kevin, for taking the time.